Welcome to the online math class of class 11. Previous day, we are discussing about the hyperbola and we have already discussed about the first form of the hyperbola. Today, we will discuss about the second form, that is y square by a square minus x square by b square equals to 1. Okay, this is the second standard form of the hyperbola. Previous day we have discussed already the first standard form. So the figure will be of this type. So first of all, the transverse axis. Here the transverse axis will be the y axis, okay, and the conjugate axis, that is the x axis. So the equation of the transverse axis, tell me. So the equation of the transverse axis, that is the y axis, so that means it will be x equals to 0, and the equation of the conjugate axis, that is the x axis, that means it will be y equals to 0. Okay. Now next, length of the transverse axis, length of transverse axis, that will be 2a unit. Length of transverse axis, that will be 2a unit. Now the length of the conjugate axis, so a means here semi-transverse axis, length of semi-transverse axis, and b means length of semi conjugate axis. That will be 2b unit. Okay. Now coming to the center. Center is here 0, 0. Center 0, 0, that is 0, 0. Okay. Now the next thing, that is the vertices. Vertices 0, comma a and 0, comma minus a. So the vertices 0, comma plus minus a. Okay. Now coming to the eccentricity e, you know that for hyperbola I am erasing this information, this formulas. You know that eccentricity is always greater than 1. Here e equals root over 1 plus b square by a square, which is always greater than 1. That is the eccentricity. Now coming to the foci, there is a plural of focus, foci. There are two focus, s and s dash, 0 comma a e and 0 comma minus a e. So foci 0 comma plus minus a, very important thing. Now the distance between two foci, distance between two foci, that is obviously 2a. All the formulas are very much similar to the formulas of ellipse. Okay, Next thing, the length of the latus rectum. Length of latus rectum. That is 2b square by a. Perpendicular chord passing through the focus. Okay. 2b square by a. Now, the equation of latus rectum. Equation of latus rectum. Y equals to plus minus a. It is a line, actually two lines parallel to the x-axis. You know that the line, the equation of the line parallel to the x-axis always y equals to constant. Okay, always y equals to constant because it is passing through the, it is parallel to the x-axis. Now, also it is passing through the point 0 comma a and 0 comma minus a. So that's why this line, equation of this line, this latus rectum will be y equals to a, and this one y equals to minus a. Okay. Now coming to the directrices. Directrices. Equation of directrices. That is also y equals to plus minus a by e, because it is passing through the point 0 comma a by e and 0 comma minus a by e. Okay. Now the distance between two directrices. That will be 2a by e. These are all the formulas regarding to the second form of the hyperbola. Now, we will move on to the exercise. Previous day, we have done one problem regarding the first form of hyperbola, that is the question number 1 of 11.4. Today, we will do question number 2. So, move on to question number 2 of exercise number 11.4. Exercise number 11.4, page number 262, question number 2. Here it is y square by 9 minus x square by 27 equals to 1. So now, comparing to the standard form, if y square by a square minus x square by b square equals to 1, we get a equals to, here a equals to 3 and b equals to root over 27. Isn't it? A equals to 3 and b equals to root over 27. Also, here the transverse axis will be the y axis and the conjugate axis will be the x axis. This is the second form of hyperbola. Okay. So now, you are asked to find here the foci, vertices, eccentricity and length of latus rectum. So, first of all, find E, that is root over 1 plus B square by A square. So, root over 1 plus 27 by 9. So, root over 36 by 9. That means it will be 2, isn't it? You also do it in your copy and respond me here E equals to 2. Now, the foci 0 comma plus minus a e. So So 0 comma plus minus a means 3, e means 2. So 0 comma plus minus 6, that is the foci, isn't it? You also do it in your copy and then respond me. Okay. Now the vertices. Vertices 0 comma plus minus a. So 0 comma plus minus three. Isn't it? Now the last thing, length of lattice rectum. That will be 2b square by a. So 2 into 27 by 3. So it is 18. Length of lattice rectum will be 18. So that is our question number 2. Now we will move on to question number 3. I am erasing this one. Question number 3. That is 9y square minus 4x square equals to 36. So, first of all, dividing both sides by 36, you will get y square by 4 minus x square by 9 equals to 1. That is our equation number 1. So, comparing with the standard form, that is y square by a square minus x square by b square, we get here, comparing 1 with this one, we get a equals to 2 and b equals to 3. So, length of the semi transverse axis will be 2 and length of the semi conjugate axis will be 3. And here the transverse axis will be y axis and conjugate axis will be x axis. Okay. So, now first of all find e root over 1 plus b square by a square. So, root over 1 plus 9 by 4. So, root over 13 by 4. So, root 13 by 2. You do it in your copy and then respond me the value of E. Okay, this is E. Now, the foci 0 comma plus minus AE. Here A means 2 and E means root 13 by 2. So, it will be 0 comma plus minus root 13, that is the foci. Now the vertices, the vertices 0 comma plus minus a, so it will be 0 comma plus minus 2, isn't it the vertices. Now the last thing, that is the length of lattice rectum. I am erasing this portion. Length of lattice rectum, that is 2b square by a. So, 2 into 3 square by 2. So, it will be 9. Okay. Length of lattice rectum will be 9. So, today we have done up to question number 3. Next day we will be back again here with a new class and we will solve from question number 4. Till then, goodbye and have a nice day.